Hello, this is Varsha and we will be painting this beautiful landscape with acrylics.
So let's get started. We'll start by painting the sky first. For that I am using Artishield size 8 flat brush.
While working on landscape, always start with doing the background first. So here we'll start painting the sky first. For that I am using the marine blue color and we'll build a gradient from light purple to pink. Now using a light purple shade and combining it with the previous tone for blending, the simple step is to move your brush back and forth from bottom to top direction. To achieve a smooth gradient, you need to work fast because acrylics dry quickly, and don't stop your strokes in between, just blend it completely from one direction to other. Now adding a layer of pink and merging it with the previous shade. Don't add too much of water to your paints when you are trying to achieve a smooth gradient, and also clean your brush every time you switch to a different color tone. Now I'll be adding a layer of white and merge it with all the previous tones. It's completely fine if you don't get a smooth blend in like your first layer. You can go in for a second layer on top of it. When you are done applying all the layers to make it more smoother, you can blend it using a damp brush. The same back and forth technique you have to use for blending, but this time you don't have to add any paint to your paintbrush. Just simply move a damp brush on top of it. After applying the first layer, still I feel it can be more smoother, so for that I am using a size 12 brush and again applying the same layers as we did previously. As you can see, the second layer made it more smoother. Now we'll be painting the mountains in the front. For that I am mixing burnt sienna and black and adding a base layer for the mountain using a size 2 flat brush. Now we'll paint the water part. For that I am using cobalt blue and merging it with pink using a same size 8 flat brush.
Here I am mixing emerald green and Persian blue for the grass base. Before starting to add details to your painting, always do the base layer first. Doing a base layer will help you to cover the entire white of the paper and will also give you a basic idea about what elements will be placed where. Here I am using size 00 round brush for adding the details. Using burnt umber for the first layer of detail, adding few random strokes from top of the mountains moving towards the downward side. Also, when you are working with acrylic, go from the darker tone to lighter tone and add layers on top of layers. Now we'll add a second layer on top of the mountains. For that we'll be using burnt sienna. The only thing you have to make sure while doing the second layer is don't entirely cover your previous layer. Let each and every layer show through when you add layers on top of layers. Now for the final layer of highlights, we'll mix burnt sienna and white. Thank you. Now we'll be painting few pine trees in front of the mountains. For that I am mixing burnt umber and sap green together, and we'll be painting the trees with a size 0 detailer brush. The pine trees are not perfectly detailed and clear, so that's why I'll paint them as straight strokes. Now I'll be adding the water highlights, you may also call them as water waves, with different shades of blue and pink. For that I'll be mixing blue and pink and purple with white and add in few horizontal strokes. For the first layer, mixing the Persian blue with white and adding in the horizontal strokes. Don't repeat the pattern, just paint them randomly. To add in more depth into the waves, just adding few darker tone highlights using Persian blue color, and this time also I am using a size 0 detailer brush. Now mixing white and pink to add in few light pink strokes. Now adding in few leaves on the left hand side by mixing green and Persian blue and using the dabbing technique for the same. I am using a flat brush to do the dabbing, and the tiny details on the tree I am painting with a size 00 detailer brush. Now painting in the tree reflection with the same color using a size 0 detailer brush. It has a very fine tip, so it gets easier to paint tiny little details. So now we'll start painting the grass strokes. For that I'll mix sap green and yellow together for the first layer. Keep it slightly darker so as for adding the next layer you can add in yellow to the same color mix to make it lighter. Here I'm flipping the paper to paint the grass stroke because that way I find it more easier and comfortable to paint. While painting the grass stroke, try to paint each and every grass stroke very closer to one another, and it will help you to bring in more volume to your grass stroke, and try to paint them as thin as possible. Avoid painting like heavy thick strokes. If you wish to buy Artishields art brushes, you can buy them from their website, which is artishields.in. Also the link will be available in the description box below. Now again you can add in some yellow to make your green slightly lighter than your previous layer, and again start adding the grass strokes on top of your previous layer. Also to add in more depth to your painting, you can add a darker strokes of grass in between. Now for painting the florals, I am just allotting the dots which will be the center portion of each and every floral. For that I am using yellow shade. Once we add a dot, it becomes easier to add in the petals too. So for painting the petals, I am using the same marine blue color which we used on the top layer for the sky, and you can add in few highlights in few of the petals using the same lighter tone of purple shade. Now again mixing sap green and yellow for making the leaves, but this time try to make it lighter than all your previous layers so that it will get highlighted. Then flipping in the paper to add in more grass highlights. I hope that you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Artisans Art Brushes YouTube channel and share your painting with us on Instagram if you recreate. Our Instagram handles are mentioned in the description box below. Thanks for watching.